Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, people, they's, him, hers, whoever you are and identify as, welcome to Acquired Taste. Today we're doing what we usually do, which is listen to great Korean music, whether it's hip-hop, R&B, pop, whatever it is, and we give our awesome professional opinions from this side of the couch. Today we're going to be watching Neve. N-I-V-E, but it's pronounced Neve. Don't get it twisted. Maybe I Wanna Die, that's the name of the song. Jisoo Park, born June 9th, 93, better known as a stage name Neve, is a South Korean singer, songwriter, producer, and composer. He made his first public appearance as a contestant in the South Korean talent show Superstar K-6, where he finished in the top 9, at the time appearing as Brian Park. Neve released his first single. Yeah, you got hella aliases. That boy is a shadow. Neve released his first single in November of 18. Neve has also written, composed, and produced songs for major K-pop artists, including BTS, EXO, NCT, Chen, Paul Kim, Sam Kim, Jung Si-woon. He has an extensive... So you're basically like Frank Ocean, Neo...
He would be...
So you know the artistry. Now you're just putting yourself out in a sense. Mm-hmm. Maybe I Wanna Die is the second track on his 2021 EP, Broken Kaleidoscope. Nice. Fun fact, he was born in South Korea, but moved to Australia in the middle of elementary school. When he was 13, he moved to New Jersey for high school. And then he went to college for a year in New York. He has since then gone back and forth between LA and South Korea. He is currently based in California.
Hi, so we're going to work together. Cool. Right. Sounds so awesome.
Our age.
Have we listened to him before?
You're Jibble. Today's the day.
I feel like that was like another artist that had like a well-rounded, I lived everywhere situation.
Probably.
Who?
Jay.
Oh, wait.
From Day 6.
Oh, really?
Oh.
He was born in LA, but he's like Argentinian.
Oh, okay. Okay. I want to stay here for like a night.
Oh, and this?
Yeah.
Right.
Or the weekend. A 4-day weekend. Oh, you sing, sing. Got that timber in his
voice. I was gonna say the opposite. Damn.
I know I'll be balling.
But that's why I want to. I feel like this is gonna hit a deep rooted spot that I need to probably get hit with.
I said, this is it. I already feel it. I said, I don't need it.
I was sitting on this couch. Like, it took me to a whole nother place already. Like, we're not even done with the song yet, and it took me somewhere else. I had to, like, bring myself back, like, oh, we sitting on a couch right now.
We filming,
like.
Yeah, I'm just here.
So first of all,
what the fuck, dude?
For sure. Yeah, definitely there is a spirit that follows people like you and people like Frank Ocean and people like singer-songwriters, even like Ryan Leslie. People like songwriters, there's a spirit that's over them, yo, because that, like, in thinking about the process of what he could possibly do to make this song, all I saw was like someone sitting in a big chair, and there's like a big desk in front of them, and there's literally nothing in the room, right? And all you see is their brain, and it's like a washing of motion, and they just pull out G chord, B chord, and they're just like, they're just doing this the whole time. I just see him just like, oh no, 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 no. So, and being pulled into this man made a song that feels like, it not only feels like the end of college, it feels like you're skipping school, it feels like comfort next to a fireplace. You made a song that really feels like after the rain, before the rain comes. That is how I felt with this. This man is an artist. This man is an artist. And the fact that it only has 100,000 views in a few months, wow. Wow. Y'all catch him. Catch him before he gets off. Catch him before he takes off. Catch him.
Yeah.
Catch him.
This made me want to do a visual of like maybe creatives. So basically us, like all the things that we do like in our life and like what we are participating in, and then having like scenes also where it's like our low moments where we're like, dang man, I'm doing all this shit, but is it enough? Hey, or dang man, like
what?
Sorry. It feels like walking into a corner that never ends. If that makes sense.
No.
Okay. Okay. Like the process of like when you're okay, for me, like walking to a corner for me, it's kind of like a like an isolation thing.
Okay.
But it's like as far as you try to like nestle yourself in this corner, you'll never get there. So you're ultimately just like continuing to like find that comfortable space away from people. So it's like you're ultimately always doing this. No matter how far back you go, you're supported, but you're supporting yourself in like isolation. So it's like a weird, like, you don't have to have a hoodie on, you don't have to have a blanket on, but you keep like blanketing yourself, and you keep blanketing yourself, and you keep blanketing. That's what the song felt like. You keep blanketing yourself with something. You know what I'm saying? So, I don't know, man. This man did it. All right, let's get into the next video. We're going to do AT's Turbulence. If you guys haven't heard of AT's, got some information for you. So, AT's is an 8-member boy group that debuted in October of 2018 under KQ Entertainment. On December 10th of 2021, just a few months ago, they released their 9th EP, Zero, Fever Epilogue, where Turbulence serves as one of their two title tracks on the EP. Turbulence is a ballad that is heartfelt and beautiful. It might be a departure from what they usually put out, i.e. intense tracks, but it is just as excellent as their other releases.
Alright, this is about to be emotional.
AT's yeah, Turbulence.
An emotional episode.
She just put all the emotional shit in one thing.
Also, now it's KQ. Oh, it was big hit. Now, okay, got it.
Wait, what?
Not with 18. Big hit. Oh. Which was said. It was different from their usual vibe. Mm-hmm. But I liked it because I feel like we have heard another slow song from them, I feel like at least once. But it was a lyric video. So being able to see like a visual and hear the song, mm-hmm. I liked it a lot. It was very cool. I feel like enjoying the fact that they were all in their own little like scenes, like they had their own little stories, which was, I don't know, I liked it. It wasn't a lot, like there wasn't a lot going on, which was kind of awesome.
Yeah,
because there's usually a lot.
True.
But I liked it.
I appreciated the fact that this AT's video was more practical in its message rather than like magical and fantastic, fanatical, so to speak. I think it brings a level of humanity, I want to say, and connection into their music and into their visuals because, you know, again, I'm used to seeing them with, like, very big
things
you got to stick with and everything.
Makes it very relatable.
Nice. For me, I think I'm just adjusting to it, but because I've grown accustomed to seeing bigger, more vibrant, louder things from them, maybe the video itself in its minimalist nature seemed as if it was missing an element of something, and it wasn't so much like it needed sounds or it needed lights, but I felt like there was like a piece of a connection that not necessarily wasn't really needed, but without it, this is the result. And I'm just like, okay, then there's something that could have been added to it to just make, to just like do this to it.
Maybe it's a little bit more of like the backstory, because we don't really know what the story is.
Right, maybe that's
we just
it.
Saw them in their separate, you know, things that they're doing, but it was very stagnant. Like, they're not going anywhere, they weren't doing anything. The only one we saw going anywhere was the one that was flying.
Right, I was
gonna
say,
it took off.
Yeah, that was the only thing. So I feel like maybe a backstory, like...
But I mean, and now talking about it and now expressing it verbally, I feel like that's not a bad way to tell stories.
Uh-huh. Mm.
It seems like kind of what we do with the dissociative interface, with
allow
the whole
people to
10 minutes in the beginning. 10 minutes. Yeah, it's like instead of we giving you the meat of the story, the reason why it's happening, we're giving you like where they were in the beginning and kind of like where they're heading to towards the like right, like towards the climax. Mm-hmm. But we don't show anything else. We just show like, oh, he's sad and now he's running and he's flying. It's like, so what happened? Doesn't matter.
Right, you come up
you
can, with
right,
the story.
You exactly, you interpret it.
So, yeah, that is pretty
so
cool.
So I feel like it's that's actually a really cool way to tell a story when it comes to music videos. So again, y'all pay attention to what you're seeing in K-pop, pay attention to what you're seeing in media, pay attention to what you're seeing on the screen. But if this is deemed successful, I hope to see this storytelling, what's the word I'm looking for? Style, there we go. This style of storytelling to continue in music videos, amongst other things, because I think it'd be dope. I think this way it really forces your audience to interpret what you're putting out, rather than you giving basically as much of a gutter guideline as you can and be like, well, think of it however you want, but these are the guidelines. It's like, nope, this is, you got this, you got that, and somewhere in between is the story. Figure it out. And you're like, all right, well, maybe there was this and this. Boom, perfect. So I appreciate that. It creates room for art, room for life itself. Mm. Thank you guys for being here for Quiet Taste. It's been some very very emotional episodes, but please get into AT's Turbulence and Neve. Maybe Y'all Wanna Die.
Yes.
Support your artists. Oof. Support art, energy, and emotion. And you'll be here from us for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all see us soon. See y'all next time. Peace.